Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Tasha, this is Tasha Pivots, and today we're gonna talk about art. How do I teach it, what do I use, and how do we build our inner artist? If you'd like to hear more, let's get started. And let's dive in. So I have been a student of the arts for a very long time. I graduated with a bachelor's in fine arts and truly love everything from art to art in itself, like painting and sculpting, to music, to photography, to just all the things, to dance. And so I am excited to really build this out for my kids and create a space for them to really cultivate the inner artist within them. I believe everyone is an artist in some form or way. If you can draw a stick figure, that's still an artist in my mind, because at least you can get the semblance of the body down. It's a starting place. And so I just wanted to show you guys some of the things that we've been using. So the first one is this beautiful book. It's the Arts Visual Encyclopedia by DK. All their books are fabulous. I really enjoyed this one. It breaks it down into different categories, as you can see with these color codes. And I'm gonna show you, and then into many categories within that. So the first one is like paintings. And I love this because it gives you the time period in which you're looking at. So if it's Mayan and Greek and Roman art, it'll talk about that time period. It'll give them some factual information from dates to artists to mediums that were used during that time. I love that it will go into the Renaissance period and just talking about the School of Athens and the beautiful paintings that were created during the historical times. So it's great for an art historian or also just wanting to teach art history. I think this is a great fundamental book to have in your library. Again, I love that it continues on into sculpting. So I'm gonna show you guys, there's that. It'll break it down into ancient sculpture, to Renaissance sculpture, to even just modern, when modernism came in. And I love that. I have a lot of pottery in our home and I can't wait for my girls to sit down and start sculpting things out and building with their hands. So we have that. We even have early photography. Some of these you might recognize already, but it just is rich, like the way it's broken down from music to different types of music. With us having a piano player in the house, this is even just gauging for her to take and spend some time even looking within this book when we're not even studying the art. And then to dance, and that then is Miss Josephine. She's our dancer, she's our sunlight type. She's the one that's gonna have music on. She'll turn on a song and she'll use this entire living room as her dance floor. And so I love this book to really just give them some foundations to look through as a reference book. All right, y'all, I'm super excited to do this video. If you haven't already, please hit that red subscribe button if you want to see more on our homeschool journey and all of those things, and from mamahood to wifehood to all of the journeys and ins and outs. Also give this video a warm thumbs up if you already are enjoying it thus far, and let's dive in. So the other one that I truly love is this one. This is A Child's Introduction to Art, The World's Greatest Paintings and Sculptors by Heather Alexander. And I love this because it comes with, it's again, going into that history, but also gives them some fun activities to do. So So I'm going to show you guys kind of like the inside. This is great for some story time if you designate a time for your art. It also, I love the activities I was saying earlier. So for instance, they have a whole thing for Michelangelo that I loved where I can take some decorative paper, or not even like easel paper, like large maps of watercolor paper, and tape it underneath our table, and they can sit underneath and act like Michelangelo and see what it was like to create upside down art like he did in the Sistine Chapel. Isn't that cool? That is so awesome to me. And that's like in almost every category, guys. So each one that you see about each different artist. So these ones are more like primary artists that you would learn in art history. And I can't wait to just develop that with my kids. So these are the two books that we're using for our art curriculum. And when I say curriculum, I mean it loosely in a sense. So for instance, our curriculum is Charlotte Mason style. We already do a lot of illustrating and visual painting, and those things are kind of happening weekly, right? But I do designate a time for just art history once a week where we get the table set and we get started and we'll study that art and we'll depict that actual art piece. Or we'll do freedom days where, like on a Friday, when all of our schoolwork is completed but we want to paint and we want to do some artwork, I'll bring out everything. We'll also do a story, and then I'll say, hey, you guys are free to either depict the image or you can paint whatever you would like. So I love that. I wanted to show you guys some of the supplies that we use. This is not a sponsored video, first of all. Second, it's just things that I've picked up, I've collected over the years that we use. Like, this is our brushes. I do not buy super fancy brushes. There's maybe a few really nice starter acrylic level one for my girls, because they're just learning to just get the paint on the paper. They're learning about the color wheel and primary and secondary colors. And so I don't want them to feel overwhelmed with like, oh, am I using the right brush? You know, eventually, like, my oldest will start to notice, like, when she wants to get into those really small, tiny pieces of details, she'll use a pointer, very tiny pointer brush. But again, these are just basic brushes I've picked up along the way from Hobby Lobby or even Michael's. And some of those things, like I said, you'll see here. I love these Kanzen binder journals. I buy them usually in bulk, so I'll buy, when they have them, buy one get one half off or buy one get one free. I just collect them. These are their little journals. I have one, this one's actually will say Zoe's nature journal on it that she paints in. But I love these. They're perfect for them to be able to, you know, open the page. If I can get that out, open the page, fold it, and then they can just sit it and paint the image that's in front of them, or they can rip it out and we can clip it to a board and have that. Another thing is, this is our container of watercolors. As you can see, I have ones that we've loved on really well, taken the things off of it. I even got this one, it's more iridescent. And then they have this new one that I just added in there just to have a secondary one up. I love having these for the acrylic. So my girls right now primarily are only using watercolor and acrylic paints and a little bit of gouache, but I'm slowly entering those, and then we'll eventually add in pastels and we'll add in oils and different things as they learn to respect the space in which they're using and respect the paint that they're using. Then we can add into those things. So I don't go crazy. Again, these were on sale for half off. This is the Master's Touch paint from, I want to say Hobby Lobby. And I just bought the primary colors because you can mix these and make multiple different colors, and it's teaching them to do the same than to just trying to buy all of them. Or you can always get the individual ones, the Artist Loft ones that you can get at Michael's that I like. So those are those. I also picked up this for Josephine. These are those like paint sticks that I thought was really cool because you can use them on multi-surface things. So if we have wood or we're using a canvas or even paper, it's not messy, it's washable. So if you know, you've got a little toddler that you want to invite, this is one of those great school items or school traditions in my home where I can get everyone to the table and I don't have to be, oh, I'm teaching this and I'm teaching that, but we all can like really paint together. And I'll play the classical music or French music, depending on the time period we're on, I'll put the music on. And it just gets us into the mode and get us into that in that season. Also, I love us some good tape. This tape is perfect for when you have, when we're doing shapes and we're doing abstract paintings and we need to cut off a certain area and we want to say, we don't want to paint that area. This is great for that. Or even just taping it, like I was doing that Michelangelo activity. Those are great. I also have some easels here I got from Hobby Lobby, and this is the best time to get them usually. I think it's because they always have them half off. And so I got this one. This one's great for if you have a toddler or younger child and it's easy, it's not too big, or if you wanna use it as a book stand. So I have the huge one here. This one has a chain that holds it together that you saw in the introduction. And so yeah, this is the things that we use. And we're just starting with painting, you know, getting the paint on the paper and mixing the colors and having fun. Kind of being able to be outside of the lines. We're not constricted to like, this is all we're covering. And it just allows my kids to express themselves in a different way and be able to relax. It really helps with, you know, if you have a child that's high anxiety or high stress, maybe introduce this to them, put on some music and have them eventually build appreciation of just flowing through painting. So yeah, I hope this inspired you. If you have any questions more on what we're doing and how we're doing it, please engage with me below in the comments. Tell me what you guys are doing for art history or art curriculum. Is there some art within already in the curriculum that you're using? And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave anything in the comments below. If you want to get a hold of me or any details that I've shared today, it will be in the description box. Give this video a warm thumbs up, as I said, and I'll see y'all in the next video. You have a wonderful day.